All right, we are live. Yippee! Good morning and welcome to On the Spot 947, where we sit down and have a little tete-a-tete with some of the biggest and talented names in the arts, and equally those who are on their artistic journey in the hopes of influencing and changing the world. Now, we just celebrated our Independence Day last week, and we are continuing our talks with artists here on the show for those who are Filipino in blood and Filipino in the heart. Now, our guest for today is someone who hails from Los Angeles, where we know has a huge Filipino population. Makes you feel like you're in Manila in many ways. I wonder what kind of food she misses and wouldn't mind trying when she does visit. But we're here to talk about songs and not food. songs that are garnering a lot of airplay and streams. The first single being Crash Landing and the recently released Nevermind. And if you have half a mind, as the British would say, you'd pay attention. Let's give her a warm welcome here at the Mellow. Good morning, Bay. Yay!
Good morning. Thank you so much for having me.
Well, glad to have you here. Welcome to On the Spot 947. Morning for us, but evening there, as I said. And good thing I got my time right. I said about 7, but you said it's about it's almost 8. Yeah. So, yeah. So I'm not too far off the mark. So, yay. Now, since we started on the topic of time, I was wondering, how do you spend your time? Like, what's a day like for Bay?
A day like for me? Okay. I usually wake up and then it takes a while to get out of bed. I think that's the same for everybody just because it's a little bit harder to find the motivation to get out of bed nowadays, especially since everything's at home.
Yeah, I agree.
Have to move a little bit, you have to exercise a little bit. I say good morning and annoy all of my family members in my house, my mom and dad, my brothers. I make it a point to always go into their rooms and just say good morning, and you know,
kind of my I love that. Annoy is the word for the day. I think I should do that to a lot of people I know.
That's my job, and then I exercise, I get ready for the day, I do any work that needs to be done, and then that's basically it. I feed my dogs, take care of my dogs, do chores.
Oh, cool. You're a dog lover too. Yay. What kind of dog do you have?
So I have two. The eldest is a Maltie Poo. He's 3 years old. And then we just got a puppy this past February. His name is, the eldest's name is Paxton. And then our baby, he is, I think, 6-7 months now. He's also a Maltie Poo. His name is Cooper.
Cool. Nice to meet a fellow dog lover. So yay, I've got two as well. I've got two Shih Tzu, although the other one's a Malshi. They're a handful. I mean, we're thinking of getting another one, but more like, are you sure we need to get another one? Because two is already enough.
So it's like,
people at the house giving me the side eyes, like, shut up about it already. Anyway, still on the issue of time, you'd agree with me that we will always spend more, if not most of our time, doing the things that fascinate us, things that somehow connects with us at a deeper level. And while you're doing it, time can just literally stop and somehow shut the world away when that happens. Do you remember the first time you discovered music or when music discovered you?
The first time I discovered music, I don't think I know a specific time, but I do remember like little bits and pieces of my childhood where I would sing karaoke with my family when we used to live with my grandma and grandpa. So I would sing Dancing Queen with my mom. I would sing, what's that pink song? It's like, I'm coming up so you get better, get this. Is it Get This Party Started?
I think that's what it's called.
So I remember that. I remember singing old Gwen Stefani songs, hearing Backstreet Boys, Destiny's Child before Beyonce went as a solo artist. So, I mean, my family has always bonded around music, whether it was singing or like learning the choreos to boy bands.
That's great. It's nice to find yourself surrounded with music all the time. And it's no surprise that why you gravitated to music, you know, later on. Child of the 90s, yay! And for artists, at times, it's the chosen artist's name that kind of like gives birth to their musical or creative identity. Can you tell us where the name Bay came from?
Yeah, so my real name is actually Isabella, which we actually spoke about before. My name is Isabella. which this is actually an exclusive, because this entire time I've been telling the story of like, oh, actually my mom and dad started calling me Bay, and then my close family and friends started picking up on it, and then hence the name Bay. But apparently my mom recently told me, I think it was a couple weeks ago, she was like, you do know that when you were a baby, you couldn't say your own name, and you would just say Bay. So you're the one who called yourself Bay. We didn't start that. You started that. And I was like, I have no idea. So you get the exclusive first story.
Yay for exclusives.
So I do get asked that question a lot, but this is the first time that I will say the true story.
Yes. You heard it right here, kids. given that a lot of iconic artists have only, you know, one name, like Madonna, Cher, J-Hut, although that's an abbreviation of sorts, Usher and Beyonce, was there ever a plan to, I don't know, put a last name to Bay? Because, you know, Bay in itself sounds fine to me too.
Yeah, so actually when I was thinking about it, it was either going with my full name or going with Bay. I think, like I said, when I thought of the backstory of Bay, it was kind of like, my nickname is Bay started off as something that I would only have a close group of family and friends call me. And just like with singing, I would only do that around like a close group of family and friends. I was very shy about it at first, even though I really loved doing it. So me calling myself Bay is kind of like the same as me being able to share a personal part of myself. Same with singing. So that's kind of why I went with Bay.
Goodness. All right. Are we back?
Yes.
Yikes. when that happens, like, oh no, Bay just froze. It's like, okay, after freezing, then I lost image. And it's like, ah, what's going on? Anyway, nice to know that we're back. So yeah, as you were saying.
Oh, what was the last part that you heard? Just so I know.
I was saying, was there ever a thought of adding a last name to Bay, or is it, you know, has it always just been Bay and no plans to add anything else?
Yeah, so I will try to remember to the best of my ability of what I said. Okay, so basically, Bay was something that my close family and friends have always called me, and just like with singing, I would do that with people who are close to me. So me being able to kind of make Bay my statement name was kind of like me being able to share something personal about myself, which is singing. So that was kind of like the metaphor that I took on with using the name Bay.
We are digging it. Bay sounds great by itself. No need for any other, you know, last name or suffix after that. Speaking of family and friends, Rizelle Alisaga says congrats at the babies. Rizelle de la Cruz Alisaga says hi at the bay. Angelie Camille also says hi.
Hi.
There's also Charina May Villanueva. And Anirvan May Javier sends a lot of hearts, as well as Angelica Louise Rosit.
Hello, Angelica.
Yeah, so these are just some friends joining us today, this morning. Growing up apart from discovering, you know, musical instruments like the ukulele and the guitar, did you also discover, let's say, any artists or artists that would later become a major influence for you?
Growing up, I think consistently one person that I followed was Beyonce, which is weirdly enough.
All right, you can't go wrong with her. You cannot go wrong with her.
She's a classic, I think, through and through. Transcends a lot.
I agree. An iconic there. I mean, you don't need to know Beyonce's last name. I mean, just simply Beyonce would do it. So, yeah, I think you're on the right track, you know, owning Bay for yourself. All right. So let's go to the first song. And that is called Crash Landing. And can you tell us the origin of the song? I kind of know the answer, but for our viewers and listeners who may not, I don't want to ruin or spoil the fun for them. Find it out directly from you. So you know me, no to spoilers.
Especially since Crash Landing is inspired by the K-drama Crash Landing.
Yeah,
so
yeah, that's right.
So Crash Landing actually came about from me and Athenis Jorge from Grace Note. She was the one who wonderfully wrote and produced the song Crash Landing. Mm-hmm. And never mind, actually, we both we worked both of the songs together. Crash Landing, it came about by us kind of talking about what we did in our free time. And one of the questions she asked me was, have you caught up on K-dramas? Just because that's super big right now during the pandemic. That's what everyone's doing during their free time.
Yes, it was.
Yeah, exactly. So it was a big boom, especially last year. And she asked me if I had watched Crash Landing. And I said, no, I haven't watched Crash Landing yet. So the song came before me actually watching the K-drama itself. But it is inspired by K-drama. It is inspired by Crash Landing and the main couple, so Captain Ri and Yoon City.
Right. Let me give our audiences a sample, and make them hear it, for those. Okay, wait. I think that was a little too loud, but yeah.
Just wanna run away and disappear, forget everything and find my way back. They say we're not meant to be like ourselves, West and East. But when they say we are surrounded by a broken heart, I think I'm gonna be something inside me. But when you're not young, can make your day so long, yeah.
At least now people have an idea of how the song sounds like. And yes, if people have been paying attention to the lyrics, you've heard the name Captain Ri mentioned so many times in that song. I take it that you've eventually finished the series.
Yes.
Right. And the character Captain Ri is certainly, you know, the perfect Prince Charming for a modern day fairy tale, and perhaps that's why it resonated so much with the local audiences. Do you watch K-dramas a lot? Do you have any K-dramas to recommend to listeners out there?
Oh, okay. So one that I watched with my mom, actually, that's kind of how we started bonding. It is Secretary Kim. It has Park Seo Joon in it.
Oh, okay. That's
like one of my tops, just because, I don't know, it's very cute. I love romantic comedies, romance.
Really got
I don't know, it's very
Yeah. Oh, okay. That was Crash Landing was actually my first foray into K-drama. I mean, my mom other titles before, and I figured, it's so cheesy. That's not my thing. I mean, give me something with fangs, with. I would rather go for that. But this one just really came out from nowhere. And once you've seen it, it hits you straight in the gut. we or go back to the songs that you may have written and figure that you could do better because of the lockdown. You had more time on your hands.
Sorry, you broke up a little bit.
Stop. Okay, let me repeat that. I said that we talked about a little bit of lockdown, and that's basically what most of us did, watching K-dramas and all other stuff that we can find on Netflix during that time. But did you find more time to write or go back to the songs that you have written and figured, I think I can do better with this one?
Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, for me, I have, I guess, always written down like little things that I think about that could be lyrics in my notes, or write it down in my journal that I used to have when I was younger. But for me, it's always a problem with finding a melody that fits what I'm feeling with words. So for me, it's easier to translate my thoughts into words, but for me to be able to make it into a song where the melody fits it is where I kind of have that disconnect, but I'm planning on working on that. Hopefully I get better at that.
Right, right. So you're more comfortable writing the lyrics than the melody, in short. You're more of a lyricist than that. Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. When the lockdown happened, and especially after everything opened up again, mental health seemed to be the key thing that a lot of people took away from that experience. How important is mental health to you, not just as a person, but also as an artist who relies so much on experience, who relies so much on internalization to write their own material?
Yeah, so I definitely think that mental health is super important for anybody out there, whether you're an artist or not, whether you're a student, you're working, a human being in general. I think all of us have some sort of introspection that we should look into when it comes to growing as a person. And I think as an artist specifically, I mean, there are a lot of things that you go through that you find to be new, and it turns out to be challenging, especially now in the pandemic. There are a lot of things that I have had to learn, especially by myself, just because, you know, my team's there in the Philippines. So feeling kind of like this overwhelming amount of pressure, and also kind of having to think about, oh, will my listeners like this? Will I have listeners? Will I continue to grow, especially with no live events? So a lot come to mind, but at the end of the day, like, I kind of just have to go back and think to myself, like, I'm working hard, you know, it's a passion of mine. And at the end of the day, you know, I wouldn't be put in a situation that I can't, you know, face. So I feel like everyone should take things one at a time, especially since we're all going through a hard time right now.
Right. Everyone's going through the same thing. And at one time in an interview, you said that writing songs is about explaining or understanding what you're feeling at the time. Have you gone back, let's say, to mine a past feeling and write about it? Because that's the perception that most people get about songwriting. You talk about the now, but it's also okay to talk about the then part, right?
Yeah, definitely. And I also think that sometimes if the emotions are too strong, you can't really think straight. So for people to kind of write about their past, it's kind of easier for you to grasp on the whole, both people's perspective. Let's say it's about two people, or I mean the whole picture of everything. So yeah, sometimes you can write about the past if you feel like it's a little too messy to think about during the present.
Right, right. Well, whatever is comfortable for you as a songwriter. True that some people find it easy to write about what happened before because you feel that there's already some sort of closure and you've resolved that issue, and it's not as painful to go back into it. Exactly. As compared to something that's going through, you know, at the moment. Yeah, so that makes sense. Let's see. Good morning as well. Some friends again keeping us company. Roberto Ignacio, good morning. Marie Julian Salon says, ganda ni Ate Bay. Yeah. Says that you look like Maricar.
Good morning.
Yeah, she's an actress here. You kind of like, you have sort of the similar hairstyle and all that. Let's see, Lilybeth says, also sends a lot of hearts, as well as, again, Angelie, Camille, and Rosel says, you're so beautiful at the Bay. Fao Faruela says, shout out from people in Alcobar in Saudi Arabia. Yeah, they're seeing us now. So,
oh, wow. How do you do?
Yeah. Christian Villarosa, good morning to you as well. And Princess Natalie Bustamante also gives you a lot of hearts. Okay, so let's move on to the second song now, which is called Nevermind. This is your latest. And let me play a little bit of that for our listeners so they can have an idea what the song is all about. And then I'll ask you what you can give me about the song. Okay. Okay, never mind. Right.
Call it quits, call it tie. I know you are never mine. Break my heart, say goodbye. I am tired of all the alibis. I cry every night, but you seem to be alright. I can't hide my fake smiles. I just had enough tonight. You don't get the pain in my eyes. You don't even try. Once upon a time, we both grabbed our side of our face. I don't see your heart in a disguise. I don't wanna fight. Sometimes you're just gonna play nice. Guess I was just blind. Never mind, never mind, never mind, never mind. Never mind, never mind, never mind, never mind.
Right, so that's how it sounds like. So you guys can of course listen to it in full. And what can you tell us about the song?
Yeah, so unlike Crash Landing, it's definitely, I would say, the polar opposite or kind of like evil twin of Crash Landing.
Yeah, that's right.
In the best way possible. So, I mean, Crash Landing is definitely about having like that, going through that honeymoon phase or like finding someone that you love that loves you back unconditionally. Whereas Nevermind is kind of like when you find a person, you guys don't work out, but you also are able to work through that and understand as somebody does feelings that, you know, you can move on and be an independent person on your own.
Yeah, that's right. Just like Beyonce, independent woman. Yay. Yeah. Sometimes you also want to play nice, but you cannot always do that, as the song goes. The song you also said was written by Eunice of Grace Note.
Yes.
Yeah. In a way, it's also a collaboration between the both of you. Would you say that these two songs perhaps can form a trilogy of an experience and should be listened to collectively and also separately? Like Crash Landing is the first, when this person comes into your life, literally lands and comes into your life without warning, and by way of a splashy entrance, takes your heart away and sweeps you off your feet. And Nevermind is like waking up to his flaws and finding out that you don't really like these flaws and you find it difficult to adjust or accept them. And when it proves to be too much, you just wanna up and leave. Now, I wonder what song number three could be all about, or have you already done song number three?
So I do actually have a third song, but I am not sure if I'm allowed to talk about it yet, because maybe things might change if I
write
a song or write another song and all of a sudden, you know, we're like, okay, we have to release this right away, or, you know, it fits this perfectly. So
That's perfectly fine. I mean, it's all part of the creative process. You can switch things back and forth, and when you've decided on what song number three is all about, hopefully it's the kind of storytelling that a lot of songwriters would aspire to, and that you take the whole thing as an experience, because that's basically what, you know, song does. It distills a particular experience into about 3 or 4 minutes, and not just the experience, but also the lessons that you learn from it. Do you have a dream collaboration perhaps with artists out there? I mean, let's shout it out to the universe. Who knows? They might be listening.
Beyonce, manifesting Beyonce.
All right, call in Beyonce. Beyonce. line one.
There are definitely a lot of international artists. I mean, even local artists that I would love to start collaborating with. I mean, there are too many to name. And also, I would just be very open to collaborating with other people and other musicians, just so I can get a feel of, you know, what kind of music, what music means to them, and also how they go through their creative process. So, you know, anything could happen.
True. I mean, anything can happen in a day, literally. Do you have a particular time of the day where you feel it's more comfortable for you to write, or any time of the day is okay with you?
Actually, it comes to me any time of the day. I could be, you know, getting ready, and all of a sudden I'm like, oh my gosh, I just thought of something that could be lyrics, and then I get my phone out of my notes, or I could be trying to sleep, and then all of a sudden I'll think of something. I'm like, I have to write it down because I'm gonna forget
Just hate that. It's like it's 2 a.m. I need to go to bed and stop, you know, monkey mind.
Stop thinking about other things. I'm just gonna go to sleep. But
true that. This month, we all know, is Pride Month. For those who are still in the dark about it, it's the month that we celebrate and observe all things LGBTQ+. I saw a YouTube video that you had with Antonio Papa. He was teaching you Pinoy gay slang.
He was
teaching in British slang. I had so much fun watching that video. But, you know, watching that video also made me feel like you have an affinity or some tie with the LGBTQ community. Can you tell us more if you have any? And if, in case you do have any message for members of the community listening right now or watching us at the moment.
Well, yes, I would just like to say happy Pride Month to everyone. You know, I think it's such a great thing that we get to have this month, just because a lot of people struggle with, I don't know, anything that they feel like they should be. So, I mean, like, a lot of people are having trouble discovering themselves or not being able to
voice it out. Yeah,
exactly. So, I mean, I'm very proud of everyone, and I'm very happy to say that, you know, I'm here for you guys. I'm here to support you, and I love you guys very much. And, you know, I mean, keep doing
You got an ally. Yeah.
I am an ally, of course, especially here in LA. We're very open-minded over here. I love growing up in a community where they support everyone.
Have you attended a Pride March before?
I've always wanted to, but, you know, there's also a lot of people there, so I don't know if my parents would allow me to go by myself or, like, with my friends who are also girls.
Yeah, and in the time of the pandemic, I don't think the march is going to happen anytime soon. So maybe, maybe next year, if in case. Yeah. So what's next for Bay?
So hopefully some collaborations in the future. Definitely more songs. Hopefully even an EP or an album. Definitely working on that. Manifesting live events to come back, just so I can finally experience my first live performance. That would be so fun and exciting. I mean, manifesting more opportunities. Not for me, but just also for everyone else in general.
I love that you use manifesting, because, you know, that's basically really what you need to be, everyone needs to be doing, you know, at the moment. If there's something that you are gung-ho about and you really want to go for it, have that image in your mind that you are actually doing it already, that you have it in your hands, so that will quicken the process of manifesting. Yeah. A little bit of law of attraction right there.
Yeah. And I definitely think if you understand your capability and what you know you can do, your potential and everything, it'll definitely come to you. It really is all about your mindset and knowing what you can do and believing in yourself.
I agree. Risa Pasqua is sending hearts and a lot of applauses. She says Tagalog song, please. Yeah, would that be also a possibility in, you know, in the works that you sing in Tagalog?
Yes. First, I would like to say hi, Mom, because that's my mom.
Hello, Tita.
Second of all, yes, I actually should probably said that, just because I actually am recording a Tagalog song. I just don't know in what order things are going to be released.
Okay.
But it is in the works.
It's in the works. All right. There you have it. Exclusive. It's in the works. Of course, listeners can stream your two songs and other. Video in all other places where digital music is being streamed or sold. I do miss the times wherein you have to go to a record store to buy a record. These days it's just so easy. I'll stream it on your phone, stream it on, you know, your iPad and all that. But, you know, nothing beats the solid, tangible, you know, feel of having a CD in your hand. So hopefully that would be something in the works for you as well. I wish you that. I wish that you manifest that as well.
I'll have my own vinyl records. That would be such a dream.
There you go. That's another one. Yes, vinyl records. Vinyl is you know, is making a comeback. Is it here to stay? Who knows? But, you know, that's how trends are. And hopefully if the trend, you know, goes on the up and up, it might actually be. So thank you so much, Bay, for being here with us. We wish you more success in your career, more songs about princes, relationships, and the work. Yes, people, there is work in a relationship that it takes to keep one. What, do you think it's stuff that you buy off the shelf, you keep it at home? No, you got to work at a relationship. It's nothing easy as that. It's not, you know, easy as picking out a toy from the shop or whatever.
But when you get a good person and you work at it, it's definitely worth it.
Exactly. I'm not voicing out issues here, but I'm just saying. But when the pandemic is over, you are certainly most welcome to drop by, most welcome to visit Talk Shop, and as the British say, spill the tea. Yeah, this has been Kaz for On the Spot 947. Till the next edition, we shall be on the lookout for the next artist that we shall be putting on the spot. So keep it right here. All hits, Melo 947 sounds good. Thank you, Bay, and we'll see you again.
Thank you so much.
All right.